we want to use the fraction wall to compare the fractions using greater than, less than, or equal. To use a fraction wall, we define the long blue rod at the bottom as one whole. So if we cut or denominate this into two equal partitions or two equal pieces, we have the 1/2 rods. If we cut or denominate one whole into three equal partitions or three equal pieces, we have the 1/3 rods. And if we cut or denominate one whole into four equal partitions or four equal pieces, we have the 1/4 rods, and so on. Similarly, we have the 1/6 rods, the 1/8 rods, the 1/12 rods, and the 1/24 rods. And now to compare the fractions, we'll model each fraction using our rods. So we'll model 3/4 using three copies of the 1/4 rod, or three 1/4 rods. So we'd have 1, 2, 3 1/4 rods to represent 3/4. And for 5/6, we would use five copies of the 1/6 rods, or 5 1/6 rods. So we'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 1/6 rods for 5/6. Notice how the train of 1/6 rods is longer than the train of 1/4 rods, which means 5/6 is greater than 3/4, or if we want, 3/4 is less than 5/6. So we'd have 3/4 is less than 5/6. Next we're comparing 3/8 and 8/24. So for 3/8, we use three copies of the 1/8 rods, or 3 1/8 rods. So this would represent 3/8. And now we'll represent 8/24 using eight copies of the 1/24 rods, or 8 1/24 rods. So we have 2, 4, 6, 8 1/24 rods. This represents 8/24. Notice how the train of 1/8 rods is longer than the train of 1/24 rods, which means 3/8 is greater than 8/24. And then for our last example, we are comparing 1/3 and 4/12. So for 1/3, we just use 1 1/3 rod. And then for 4/12, we would use four copies of the 1/12 rod, or 4 1/12 rods. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 1/12 rods for 4/12. And notice how the train of 1/12 rods is the same length as the 1/3 rod, which means these two fractions are equivalent or equal. So 1/3 equals 4/12. So a fraction wall can be a nice way to compare fractions. I hope you found this helpful.